What's up, guys? South Buck Nephi here. Play some more Madden. Well, I don't know if I want to keep this guy anymore. I'm getting irritated by the way he's playing in the NFL now. And Dominican Sue. I'm getting irritated by this, how this dude's playing. This is Thanksgiving today. Why would you kick somebody that's on the ground, really? And he says he was just going away. Really? He purposely kicked the dude, and it was a backup blocker. This dude can't control his temper at all. I should just get rid of this dude. Like, this dude can't control his temper. This dude's probably the dirtiest player in the NFL. This dude, I just can't believe how this guy plays. If I was a Lions fan, I don't know if I would want him on my team. He's good, but he's not going to bring Lions to the Super Bowl because of the way he plays. Because he just, like I said, he can't control his temper. So why, if I was a Lions fan, why would I want a dude that's just going to get suspended? And that's probably what the commissioner is going to do, suspend him. So come on. Sue, you just need to get it together. You need to stop punching people. You can play rough. Sure, play rough with the quarterback. But don't talk trash to him like you did with Matt Ryan a couple months ago or a month ago. When he's injured. Come on, Sue. Stop being a pussy and let's go. You can't kick guys on the ground. You can't be punching people because you know the refs are gonna prevent the fight from happening. So come on, really? Now, Lions are gonna be all screwed up now because you're gonna get suspended. And look what Green Bay did against you. As soon as that hole was in the middle, they ran all over you. Or they just found the hole in your defense. So Lion fans, please tell me how you feel on the way Ndamukong Suh is acting. So it might be some Lion fans that actually like that. And that's okay. But I think that's going to screw the Lions up with how Ndamukong Suh is playing. Alright, let's play this game. Dang, 82 overall I dropped down to. Damn. All Madden. That's what I'm playing on, guys, now. Since I've won 2 seasons in a row, I'm going to all Madden now. But I am going to use my playbook still. Now, I'm probably going to get crushed my first couple games, but that's okay. This is preseason. Tomorrow I might be playing a little bit of WWE 12, WWE Universe. So I know there's probably not very many WWE fans out there, but this game looks pretty good and I want to play it. So that's what I'm going to do tomorrow if I can get a hold of it. I'm going to do the WWE Universe and I'm going to create my guy and stuff.
We're here for a preseason matchup between the Jets and the Patriots. And Chris, when the Jets and Patriots get together, it always promises to be a good one.
Now, this Jets-Patriots rivalry goes back a long way beyond your typical division rivalry because of all the history with the coaches and the players who went back and forth between the teams over the years. This is an extra special matchup each and every time, and it's one that we really look forward to.
All right, Chris, with that...
All right. We've got 2 teams. See how I can do with my team now since it's on.
Comes onto the field and
oh no.
Conversation.
Wait a minute. Is this my team or? Oh, I thought this was a different team for some reason. What the heck am I doing? Sorry, guys. I'm sorry. I thought this was a different team. I forgot I had Jason Babin. I haven't played for a while now. Get into a rhythm. Let's see if he can get him.
And as we look at the key offensive players, Akeem Nicks out of North Carolina is the go-to deep threat.
And that's important when we talk about a balanced attack all the time. And if you can't stress...
There goes LeSean McCoy.
Extremely one-dimensional. Akeem Nicks is an exciting player that gives the offense that home run threat.
And Chrissy is definitely primed to be a performer to watch in this one. Gives it off.
Ah, man.
Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Prince Amukamara was there to bring him down. Only a yard needed to convert here on second down. Has a seam down the middle. He's dropped down right around the 30-yard line by Griffin. Now we have a first down and 10 to go. They spot the rock on the 30. He'll be brought down behind the line of scrimmage. As we introduce the key players on defense, we look no further than Ndamukong Suh out of Nebraska. How do you do? He's a dominant force on the D-line.
Yeah, Gus, this guy, for such a young player, is as polished as you are. He has the instincts out there of a 10-year pro, and players like him that can come in and dominate the defensive line so soon in their career, well, they're really once-in-a-generation type players.
Well, he got me a sack. I'm going to keep on. He's just upset what he's doing in actual football.
You're just blitzing one half of a formation, dropping off on the other side. We're seeing perfect.
Oh wow, I'm surprised they missed out on all Madden. Jeez.
The kick is no good. He hooked it left.
All right, Arian Foster, let's go. Uh-oh.
We'll have a first down and 10. Throws it over the middle of the field. He's tackled at about the 47.
Let's see here. What should we run? See if we can run down the middle this time.
They were coming after him, but the quick throw beat him.
Flag on the play.
Oh no, not a flag. God dang it. Breton Hancock. Let me make sure my depth chart looks pretty good. Okay, that's good. That's good. That's good. Okay, that looks pretty good. That looks good. Okay, that looks good. Might as well keep them in. All these rookie blockers are in. I might as well keep them in there for now. See how good they do. I had a right outside linebacker. I guess I don't. I'll bring Mark Ingram in on third downs. All right.
75 is flagged for a hold on the play.
I would get with this for now.
Second down, 11 yards for first. On their own, let's say 43. Goes through his progression.
Looking God dang it. I was getting... It's going to get sacked. Oh, man.
And he's loose.
closed on the ball quickly and came up with the interception.
He took a risk going for the ball there because he didn't have any help behind him, but when you're that good at closing and attacking the ball, you can certainly afford to gamble occasionally.
And it's amazing what talent can let you get away with. And just about 4 yards away here on second down. He's looking towards the left side. It's going to be first and goal for the Jets.
A good job there by the quarterback to fit that ball in there with good coverage. Yeah, and the defensive back didn't really do anything wrong there. The quarterback just made a good throw. We'll see if he starts to play a little more aggressively, maybe initiate some contact and get that receiver out of his comfort zone going forward.
That's what the thing about all Madden. They break so many broken. They have so many broken tackles. It's ridiculous.
New York is up 7. Colquitt is ready to kick it away. Jackson is deep, looking to return the kickoff. He'll return it from the 6. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. Number 86 was there for the stop.
And coming to the field, the quarterback, who hopes to lead this offense to victory in this game.
Oh, man, come on, don't drop it.
Here are the offensive starters, and it's a unit that has no shortage of big-time weapons. Chris, wideout Deshaun Jackson from Cal might be the most exciting player in football right now. Yeah, when he gets his hands on the ball, you
come on.
Gasp as if they're expecting something incredible to happen, and a lot of times it does.
Jeez, I keep dropping it. Stop it.
As many big plays as Deshaun Jackson has.
And Chris, he is definitely primed.
Quit. Oh my God, 3 straight drops. That's the one thing that's stupid about all Madden. They can't catch the ball. Oh my God.
Made solid contact and popped the ball out of it.
Yeah, he got rocked and the ball rolled.
My God, they can't catch the ball worth anything.
The offense will take over at the 33-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Palmer tosses to the left side.
Every play they get a broken tackle. Do you guys notice that?
By Bird.
Oh my God.
Taylor Mays was there to bring him down. It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Oh, my God.
And he's tackled at about the 27 by Griffin. First down and 10. Short throw to the right. Manning caught that one for a gain of 6. Second down, and they're going to need just about 3 yards to pick up the first. Manning gets a carry right side.
And when your defensive line can handle their guys up front and not allow the offensive linemen to get down on the linebackers, it really gives those linebackers a chance to look great.
Oh my God, dude. Screw that.
You know, not only the top end speed, which is so impressive, but speed in and out of his cuts. That's the difference in a great running back. Anytime you can see a guy maintain that speed out of his cuts, that's a guy that has superstar ability.
Second down, goal to goal. They line up at the 2.
Oh my God.
Touchdown.
Oh man, they're just going to keep scoring. Like, they're so cheap on offense. That's the problem with all Madden. They make it so cheap you can't even do anything. You seen, I got 3 drops in a row. They got broken tackle about every time. God dang, it's so cheap on all Madden.
And it's fielded at the four. The stop was made by Jabal Sheard. The offense will start at the 18-yard line. Now we have a first down and 10 to go.
Oh my God. Oh.
The tough part for a quarterback is trying to identify who the mic
is. Oh my God. Dang.
Is they want offensive linemen handling the big guys, handling the guy they think may be blitzing, may be rushing on a play. If you misidentify that guy, you can get hit in the back of the head. He'll get the help of the trainer, so his day just might be over. Passes out to his right.
Nice catch.
He's wrestled down right around the 36-yard line by Mathis. They give it off here, and the tackle was made by Rolando McClain.
And that's why you send all those guys to plug up the holes, and that time there were no holes, really, and he was lucky to get anything on the play.
Fires.
Oh, my God.
Hunt was the intended receiver.
Oh my, what was that? Guys, this is just so stupid. Can't do anything. Wow, this is retarded. This is retardedly gay. Oh my God, screw that. I can't believe how much the computers have the advantage.
And with that, the 2-minute warning is reached. Dawson.
Oh my God. That, guys, now that was just plain retarded there. Oh my God. Dang. This is why old Madden sucks. This is why I never played on old Madden. I just saw it. Since I've been doing so good, some of you might want to see me play on a harder difficulty. And I'm playing on a harder difficulty and it's chipping me out.
And the point after is good.
Like you would ever see that. Them breaking a tackle on every pretty much play. So stupid.
And he gathers it at the 6-yard line. Gets it to the 21. Myers was there for the stop. Surveys the field. He's dropped down around the 27-yard line by Washington. Foster made the catch for a gain of 6.
Good cover. Quit slipping! Oh my God! Oh my God, come on! This is so gay!
That's a kind of his signature move, if you will. And he's had a lot of success using it to get to the quarterback.
And it didn't look like the quarterback even saw him coming.
This is so gay.
Quick reaction time.
This is really gay. I can't believe it. Oh my God, this is so stupid.
Come up with 3 solid plays in a row like that. You know they are right on schedule. It bounces out of bounds at the 36-yard line. And they're already up big. That return just really puts them into position to make this thing a blowout. Passes short right side.
Oh my, look at that! This video should be called, this is why all Madden is really gay. Because all Madden is gay.
He's searching for a receiver.
Oh my god, there he goes.
He's free.
This is so stupid. This is so stupid.
And looks left. Throw.
I'm surprised he didn't catch that.
Number 80 was the intended receiver on the play. Dumps it out right. He's brought down around the 31-yard line by Bauer. The kick is no good.
One of the main factors that you always deal with when you're kicking in rainy conditions is the plant foot. Do you have faith that that foot is going to stay secure and that you can swing at it with the same kind of intensity that you're used to? Most kickers, you see them look a little tentative in the rain.
Has a man out to his right.
Oh my god, look at all them drops. That was pathetic.